Hello everyone. In last video, we had seen design problems on fiber reinforced to concrete. So today we will see design problems on ferro cement. So the first problem: design a crack-free ferro cement tension member to withstand a tensile force of 25 kN for the following data. Here sigma mn is equal to 3 newton per mm square, sigma fu is equal to 360 newton per mm square, load factor against cracking 1.2, 4 layers of 20 mm wire mesh is suggested, sigma cv is equal to 5 newton per mm square, trial section is taken as 300 mm by 20 mm. Now we will see the solution. First, we need to calculate dead load. So here dead load can be calculated based on the load factor and the tensile force 25 kN. So 25,000 into 1.2, we will get 30,000 newton. After dead load, we have to calculate area of composite section. Composite section is nothing but, in this case, slurry and reinforced wire mesh. So here area for composite section is equal to dead load divided by sigma cv. So just it is the transformed form of, rearranged form of load divided by area. Sigma is equal to load divided by area. So here we need to calculate area. So dead load divided by sigma cv. Sigma cv is given. Dead load we calculated, 30,000 divided by 5. So here area we got 6000 mm square. After the area of composite, we need to calculate specific surface available. SL is equal to 5dm divided by SF into T. D is the diameter of the wire, M is the number of layers of wire, SF is 6.4, that is the spacing of the fibers, into T is the thickness of the specimen, 500 into 20 mm, it is given. So put all the values here. If some in some problems D will not be given, that we need to assume at a specific spacing. So put all the values assumed and known, and we will get SL is equal to 0.0893 per mm. After that, we need to calculate cracking load, that is sigma CR is equal to sigma MN plus 25 into bracket of SL is the formula. Sigma MN is given, plus 25 into bracket of SL is calculated specific surface. Put the values and you will get 5.23 newton per mm square is the cracking load. Next is that volume fraction of wire in loading direction, VF. So that can be calculated by using the formula. M into AW is the area of a single wire divided by specific surface into thickness. So area of wire can be calculated by using pi by 4 into d square. The wire will be in circular, having a circular cross section. So area can be calculated by using this formula. Put the values known. M is the number of layers, 4. Area can be calculated. Next, SL is specific surface area, and the T is thickness, 20 mm. Put the values and we will get the volume fraction 0.0203. After calculating volume fraction, and one more thing here, we calculated cracking stress sigma CR. We need to calculate cracking load. So in that case, this can be converted to the load, means load is measured in terms of newton. So just multiply this value with the 10 raised to 4, you will get the load. Clear? And next, we need to calculate volume fraction of matrix BFM is equal to sigma mn divided by sigma fu. Sigma mn is given, 3 divided by sigma fu is also given. So that also we need to use. Here you can see 360 newton per mm square. Put both values and we will get 0.0139. So here this VFM must be lesser than the VF, then only it is permitted to use the wire and the matrix. Clear? Matrix, in this case matrix is nothing but just cement, water and the sand. Here coarse aggregates are totally eliminated from the ferro cement. Clear? And next, the strength at first crack, sigma cr is equal to 5.23 newton per mm square. It is calculated here, the strength at first crack. Next, which is 5.2 is greater than the suggested 5 newton per mm square, hence permitted. Means suggested is 5 newton per mm square, but our strength is 5.23 newton per mm square for our ferro cement. Considered a case is we are getting 5.23 newton per mm square, which is greater than the suggested, so hence it is permitted. Clear? So next problem is that a ferro cement rectangular member 500 mm by 20 mm is subjected to axial tension. It is reinforced with 6 layers of O1 mesh with wire diameter 0.91 mm and spacing 6 mm center to center, distributed uniformly across the section. Determine the cracking load, ultimate load and stress strain relationship of the composite in tension along with the spacing, and maximum width of crack of service load for the given data. So here we need to calculate 4 things. The first one is cracking load, and next ultimate load, next stress strain relationship of the composite in tension along the spacing, and next maximum width of crack for service load. So these are the things we need to calculate for the following given data: ET, that is the Young's modulus of steel 2 into 10 raised to 5 newton per mm square, sigma fu 500 newton per mm square, epsilon fu 0.015 em, Young's modulus of matrix 0.25 into 10 raised to 5 newton per mm square, sigma mn is equal to tau mn is equal to 500 newton per mm square. Sorry, it is not 500 newton per mm square, it is 2.5. Just it is a typing mistake. Here tau mn or sigma mn is given 2.5, and load factor is equal to 1.5. So now we need to calculate these 4. So these are the given data, you can see here. Capital W into capital D is equal to given. This is the rectangular section, 500 mm into 20 mm. ET is given, sigma fu, epsilon fu. Em is given, sigma mn is equal to tau mn is equal to 2.5 newton per mm square is given, and then load factor 1.5. Along with that, it is also given that diameter of the wire 0.91 mm. And spacing is also given in this problem, 6 mm center to center, distributed uniformly. First, we need to calculate ultimate load in the cracking load, and then ultimate load. So first we need to calculate cracking load. For the cracking load, we have to calculate some of the values. First, area of fiber wire along width, that is AF, is equal to capital W into 5 by 4 into D, sorry, D square. So in this case we need to calculate by using this formula, 500 into 5 by 4 into diameter of the wire is equal to 0.91 square. So you will get 325.5 mm square. Next, area of composite, area of fiber wire, and then area of composite. Composite is nothing but it is included steel and then matrix. So AC is equal to capital W into T, the given section, 500 into 20 mm. So that is 10,000 mm square. Next specific surface, SL is equal to pi dm divided by SF into T. D is given 0.91 into number of layers. If not given, we need to assume, divided by spacing of the fiber 6 mm, it is given, into thickness of the section 20 mm. Depth or thickness T, clear? Then we will get 0.1429 per mm. So these are the things what I used here. M is equal to 6 layers, T is equal to, D is equal to thickness of specimen 20 mm, SF is equal to 6 mm center to center, and D is the diameter. So after this we need to calculate cracking load. Cracking load is equal to, we have the formula, sigma mn plus 25 into bracket SL. Put all the values, 2.5 plus 25 into 0.1429 calculated value. Then we will get 6.07 newton per mm square. Just multiply with 10 raised to 4, we will get in terms of newton, because we need to calculate cracking load. Load is measured in terms of newton or kilonewton, right? So far this must be converted to the newton. Other than the first point, cracking load is calculated. Next, the second is ultimate load, we need to calculate. So for ultimate load, stress at failure we need to calculate. Sigma failure is equal to sigma Fe into volume fraction. So then we don't know volume fraction and it is not given, so that must be calculated. Vf is equal to M into Aw divided by spacing into capital D. So here M is the number of the wire mesh into area of a single wire divided by the spacing into capital D. Spacing is given, 6 mm center to center. Put the values and we will get 0.0325. Volume fraction will not have any units. Put this V up and sigma Fu is given 500 newton per mm square, we will get 16.26 newton per mm square is the stress, it is the strength at failure. Then this stress value must be converted to the load, then multiply the 10 raised to 4, then you will get in terms of load 1,62,600 newton. So the ultimate load is also we calculated. Next, the third one we need to calculate, that stress strain relationship, or else you can say modulus of composite. That is modulus, Young's modulus is nothing but stress by strain. So here we are studying the stress strain relationship. You can also say this as modulus of composite. So here modulus of composite, EC is equal to EM into bracket of 1 minus B of volume fraction plus Young's modulus of steel into volume fraction. So this is the formula we need to use. Here these are the things we know, EM and ET, and here we calculated VF. Put the values, we will get 0.3069 into 10 raised to 5 newton per mm square. So this is the EC. Next, after that, modulus of rupture at a cracked state. When the cracks induced, then only there will be the strain induced. Clear? Along with the strain, there is a change in the volume along with the original, change in the length along with the original length. Clear? So here ECR is equal to ET into VF. ET is given, 2 into 10 raised to 5. We have calculated 0.0325. Then multiply, we will get the value. After this, service load. So the question is that we need to study the stress strain relationship. Clear? And maximum width of crack at service load. So far we need to calculate the service load. Clear? So here service load is equal to ultimate load into 1 by load factor. Ultimate load we calculated into 1 by load factor is given, 1.5. So then we got that 1,08,400 newton. Next is cracking stress. Stress is nothing but load by area. So cracking stress is equal to service load divided by area of fiber. Already we calculated AF. Put the values, we got cracking stress 3333.3 newton per mm square. So after calculating the cracking stress, so this is the stress strain relationship, stress and then strain. Clear? So now we need to calculate maximum width of crack. First we have to calculate the spacing of crack and then crack width. Here we have the formula for the spacing of crack, sigma mn by d into am by w into 1 by tau mn. Put the values, sigma mn is given, am, how to calculate the am? Am can be calculated, here you can see, we have area of composite, am is nothing but area of matrix, matrix is nothing but cement, sand and water, sorry, cement, sand and water. So area of composite is nothing but width included steel. So steel must be removed. So area of fiber we calculated. So AC minus AF is equal to AM. Clear? AM is equal to AC minus AF. Then 10,000 minus 320.5 will get this value. 9674.5. After getting this, D is given. W is the given, tau mn 2.5, that also given. So then spacing of crack is 21.26 mm. Then we need to calculate crack width, small w is equal to diameter of the wire divided by spacing. Put the values here, spacing we calculated, then the crack width, the maximum crack width is 0.042 mm. So in this way we need to calculate or to design the ferrocement. So thank you. For your extra problems, refer the recent year question papers. Thank you.